Hello friends, today I'll see the Node.js topic. Node.js is an open source server-side framework. It is free. It runs on different platforms like Windows, Linux, Unix, macOS, etc. It also uses a JavaScript on server-side. Using Node.js, you can generate dynamic web page contents. You can create, open, read, write, delete, and close files on the server. You can collect the data from form data. You can add, delete, modify data in your database. Node.js file contains tasks that will be executed on certain events. A typical event is someone trying to access a port on the server. The extension for Node.js file is .js. Here is one simple comparison I have added on PHP or ASP and Node.js. We take one simple example, like a common task for a web server can be to open a file on server and return the content to the client. In PHP, the steps are like, very first step is send the task to computer's file system. Then second, server will wait while file system open and read the file. Then return the content to the client, and then server is ready to handle the next request. Means until this step 2 and 3 is not done, the server is in a waiting state. But what happened in a Node.js, it sends the task to the computer's file system and without waiting, it's ready to handle the next task. So Node.js eliminates the waiting and simply continues with the next request. Node.js runs a single-threaded, non-blocking, asynchronous programming, which is very memory efficient. So this is all about the simple introduction of Node.js. Now we'll move toward the studs. In STUTS overview, Apache STUT 2 is an elegant, extensible framework basically used to create the enterprise-ready Java-based application. This framework is designed to streamline the full development cycle from building to deployment and maintaining application over the time. Start to have a very much different features. We go one by one. The very first feature is configurable MVC component. As Start is depend on MVC pattern and it configure all the settings in .xml file, web.xml file, where all configuration details, start.xml file, where all configuration details are available. So if any change of information is required in a configuration, you only need simply change the XML file. Second is a POJO based action. POJO means it is a plain old Java object, that is a simple Java class. So you need not forced to implement any interface or inherit any class. So very simple and basic Java code is used in Start 2. Third is Ajax support. Start 2 provides the support to Ajax technology, and everybody knows that Ajax is an asynchronous request, so it does not block the user, so it makes the performance faster. The next is integration support. In Start 2 application, you can integrate many different frameworks like Hibernate, Spring, Tails, etc. It have a different result type, means after generating a result, the result can be displayed using a different technology like JSPD, FreeMaker, Velocity, etc. The next is a various stack support. The STAR2 provides various types of tags such as UI tags, data tags, control tags, etc., which makes a easy development of STAR2 application. And last is theme and templates. STAR2 provide a support to the three types of themes like XHTML, simple, and CSS HTML. So this is all about the different features of STAR2. Next is the architecture. STAR2 is based on MVC based web application. MVC means model, view, and controller. And that model is basically used to maintain and store the data and business logic of application. View model is responsible to display the data, that is, it represents the presentation. And controller module acts as an interface between view and model. In STAR2 application, there are five different components like action, interceptors, value stack, result or result types, and view technology. This is a STAR2 application, STAR2 architecture. So how the STAR2 application work using this architecture or cycle? So it is a request life cycle. In this, based on this diagram, you can understand the workflow through user's request lifecycle in STAR2 as follows. User sends a request to the server for requesting for some resources, that is pages. The filter dispatcher looks at the request and then determines the appropriate action. Action is available in model. Configured interceptor functionality applies, such as different validation on the input or file upload, etc. Selected action is performed based on the requested operation. Again, configured interceptors are applied to do any post-processing if required. Finally, the result is prepared by the view and return the result to the user. So all these five components are divided in model, view, and controller. So this is the architecture and life cycle of STAR2. STAR2 architecture have different advantages, like navigation control is centralized. It is very easy to maintain, easy to extend, easy to test, and better separation of concern. We'll see the better separation of concern in next video. And some limitation of this architecture is we need to write the controller code itself. If we change the controller code, we need to recompile the class and redeploy the application. So if you change your code, you have to recompile your class and again redeploy the application. This is the main disadvantage of STAR2 application or STAR2 architecture. Now next we'll go with what are the different configuration files required to run any STAR2 application. So here you will see that this is a table where you will find out the different configuration file. These are mandatory or optional. Where you can find out this file in your web app and what is the purpose of this file. So very first file is a web.xml. It is an optional. It is stored in web-inf folder. And its purpose is web deployment descriptor to include all necessary framework components. It stored all the components required for framework for web development deployment. Second is a studs.xml. It's optional and it is stored in web-inf classes file. It is a main configuration file which contains results, view types, action mapping, interceptors, and so forth. Next is default.properties. It will be available in wavinf-again classes folder, and it stores the framework properties. Next is studs-default.xml. It is available in wavinf leaf folder stud2core.java folder. And it purposes default configuration provided. Here it stores the default configuration provided by studs. Next is stud-default.vm. It again stored in wavinf/classes. It is a default micros referenced by velocity.properties. studs-plugin.xml. It is available at the root of the plugin jar. It is an optional configuration file for plugins in the same format as studs.xml. Last one is velocity.properties. It is available on wavinf/classes folder, and it overrides the default velocity configuration. So this is all about in studs. Stud architecture, stud application, and stud configuration files. We'll see the next points in next video. Thank you so much for watching.